Three artists. Sylvia Plath, poet of the 20th century. Arshil Gorky, abstract expressionist of the 1930s and 40s. Hawthorne Heights, contemporary emo band. On one mission. To express suppressed feelings through their artwork. Sylvia Plath was a poet in the middle of the 20th century. Connections between her poetry and her life are extremely obvious. Her poems act as portholes to her innermost feelings. They allow her to express her emotions filled with melancholy, rooted in past poor personal relationships with others. However, Plath was not the only poet of her time, or artist for that matter, to use his cathartic style. Abstract expressionist Arshil Gorky employed his artwork in a similar fashion, for his paintings acted as places where he could release his most gloomy emotions, rooted from horrific events in the form of artwork. He painted with automatism influence, which is painting with the unconscious mind. This particular style makes it extremely easy to capture and pinpoint emotions that Gorky was feeling at the time. He painted one of his most famous paintings entitled Agony in 1947, 1 year before his suicide, where a series of tragic events are depicted in this painting. He suffered from a broken neck and a house fire. As well, he discovered that his wife was having an affair in this final period of his life. These events are blatantly alluded to in this painting. The figure on the right-hand side of the painting looks as if his head was being chopped off, and both the neck and the head is covered in blood. This must symbolize the broken neck that he suffered from. The extensive use of red in the background of the painting suggests an image of a fire. Coincident? I think not. Also, the chromatic use of red captures the painful emotions that he must have been feeling as a result of discovering a cheating spouse. Pure agony. Connections between Arshil Gorky's life to his artwork is clearly visible, just as they were with poet Sylvia Plath. But this cathartic style is not just limited to artists of the 20th century. This style is also employed by contemporary artists of today. The band Hawthorne Heights is a rock band with emo influences. Emo is a word that describes a genre of music and comes from the word emotional. Emo music contains confessional lyrics that express deep emotions. According to Aaron Bussarelli, a member in the band, the vocalist, JT, designs his lyrics by relating them to failed relationships. Sylvia Plath designed her stanza in a very similar fashion. The song Ohio is for Lovers in the album Silence in Black and White of 2004 employs the cathartic style as the band expresses the gloomy emotions felt as a result of a breakup between a young man and his lover. The failed relationship took such a profound effect on the boyfriend that he is contemplating to inflict pain on himself by cutting his wrist. The hurt from the breakup is so bad that the boyfriend feels as if his lover has killed him well. Three artists. Sylvia Plath. Hawthorne Heights. Arshil Gorky. One mission. Created by Logan Schoon.